Hello everyone, Stormy Strike here, and in this video I'm going to be showing how I inventory my model horse collection and give ideas on ways you can inventory your own collection. This video is Briar focused and focused primarily on traditional scale Briar models because that's what I primarily collect, but you can still use the information in this video with other scales and models like Peterstones, Artist Resins, Medallions, Schleichs, or even non-equine models you collect. Before we begin inventorying, let's first go over the reasons why people inventory their collection in the first place. One of the main reasons is for insurance purposes. Many collectors will insure their collection, and inventorying your collection gives a more accurate account of your models and how much they are all worth. If something were to happen to your collection, collector's insurance will help recoup the cost. Another major reason people inventory their collection is so that if something were to happen to you, whoever takes over your collection won't be completely blind as to what your collection consists of and how much everything is worth. In other words, it's a way to help ensure your collection doesn't end up being sold off at a yard sale for basically nothing if something were to happen to you. Now, those two reasons are on a darker note with the worst case scenarios, so let's move on to the more positive reasons to inventory your collection. This next reason is simple, and that is to just have your collection be more organized. By inventorying your collection, you can easier look up which models you have and don't have, as well as make it easier to find information on models in your collection. The last reason is it can be fun. Inventorying your collection may not be fun for everyone, but I've found some joy in being able to inventory my models. Plus, inventorying your models is a way to look and think about each individual model you own. You can find yourself appreciating certain models that you may overlook on your shelves. Or maybe through inventorying, you realize that there are some models in your collection that you want to part with. Whatever the outcome, inventorying your models will get you to look and think about each of your individual models. Now that we know the reasons behind inventorying, we now move on to how you should inventory your collection, or rather, what method you're going to be using. There are many different ways it can be done. There's really no right or wrong way to inventory your collection. How you do it is entirely up to you. There are two main ways to inventory your collection. The first is doing it by hand. You may want to stick to an old-fashioned route and write out all your models by hand in a notebook or on spreadsheets. An extra way to ensure your list is safe in case anything happened to the original is to make copies of it to store in another location, or even scan or photograph the pages to keep a backup digital copy. Which leads to the second and probably more commonplace method today, which is to do your inventory digitally. Even within that, there are so many different options and ways for you to inventory your collection digitally. You could do it from a computer, a phone, or a tablet. You can use programs like Excel, Microsoft Word, Google Sheets or Docs, mobile apps like Snups or iCollect, or any other various programs or apps that are out there. Use whatever program or app you think you will be most comfortable with. For myself, I like to use Microsoft Word because it's a program that I'm super familiar with and therefore it's very easy for me to use. Whichever method you go about inventorying, an important aspect is to have it backed up in some way to multiple locations, whether this be saving it on the cloud or having it saved on multiple devices, like saving a copy on your phone and then another copy on your computer, or printing out hard copies and storing them somewhere safe. Whatever way you end up using, it's always good to have a backup saved of your collection inventory. Once you've figured out how you'll be inventorying your models, the next question is, what kind of information will you be putting on your inventory list? Perhaps the most important bare minimum information is, of course, a model's name, mold, and model number, if we are talking about original finished models. But there are many other pieces of information you can add about each model. Here are examples of additional information you may want to include. Remember, these are just ideas. You do not have to include all this information on your inventory list. Only include what you think is important to have on your inventory list. Sections of information you may want to include on your inventory list includes years produced, number produced, condition, description, color, photos of the model, inventory number, price paid, when and where it was purchased, current value or worth, Any special stories behind the model? Breed, gender, pedigree information, if you do model horse pedigrees, the artist of the model for customs and artist resins. If you live or photo show, you could also include information pertaining to your model's showing history, such as show name, placings, shows entered, and class and or division that the model shows in. Again, don't think that you need to include all this information. You can be as sparse or as thorough as you wish with your inventory list. Pick and choose what pieces of information best pertain to your collection, then begin creating your list based around the aspects you've chosen. Here's an example of my own inventory list. Remember, this is just an example. You do not need to base your list off my own, although you are welcome to if you like this particular format a lot for your own collection. For my inventory, I organize everything by molds, much like on the site identifyyourbriar.com. For each mold section, I include some basic information about the mold. I put its name and alternate name if it has one, the mold number, the sculptor, and the year it was introduced. And then within those sections, I have different dedicated columns. The first column is the model's name, then the model number, and then the years it was produced. Those columns are pretty straightforward, and that information is easy to find on Identify Your Briar when I'm inventorying my briar horses. My largest column is the description and additional information. This is basically my catch-all column for any additional info I may want to include. For this column, I'll add in information like how many of a certain model were made if it was a limited edition, or what kind of exclusive it was if it was an exclusive model that's not a regular run, like a special run of some sort. Other information I may include is anything I find noteworthy about the model, such as if it has a special variation. If it's a custom, then that's where I put who painted it and or customized it and when. If it has a short story behind it, sometimes I'll put when and where I purchased it from if I think that's something significant to include. Because I also used to make briar films, I'll mention if a particular model was used in one of those films. And lastly, any other barn names or nicknames associated with the particular model. To the right of that is a column for the model's condition. I'll use various abbreviations to describe the model's condition. I even created a separate list with all the abbreviations I may use. So there is LSP for live show proven, LSQ for live show quality, Mint for a model that is factory mint, PSQ for a photo show quality model, NIB for new in box, play or shelf quality, and then body for a body quality model. The next column is the price I paid for the model. I personally find that a model's value fluctuates so much these days that instead of putting their current value, I try to keep record of what I paid for individual models instead. That way, in case I ever decide to sell a particular model, I'll have an idea of what to sell it for to at least make my money back on it. Unfortunately, I didn't start inventorying until several years after I started collecting, so I don't remember the price that I paid for everything. Sometimes I just put down an approximation of what I remembered paying for a certain model. The last two columns are for live showing, the model's show name, and then placings. Not all my models show, but I try to put down the show names of the ones that do or used to show. Sorting my model's placings is actually a whole nother video, and some of them have a lot of placings to list, so instead of listing all the placings down right now, I'm mostly just putting yes to indicate that this model does have placings and to refer to my model horse show binders to find what particular placings a model has. Now let's move on to the topic of how you organize your models within these lists. Of course, that is up to you on how you want to organize them, but here's some ideas on ways that you can list your models if you do choose to list them in a specific order. You could list your models by model number, which is actually the same order that they're listed on identifyyourbriar.com, I believe. So if you're arranging your models based on identifyyourbriar.com, that is one way to do it. You could also list the models by when they were produced, when you got them, in the order they are organized on your shelves, alphabetically by name, by color, by breed, by inventory number, etc. Do whatever way works best for you. I currently don't have them organized in a specific way yet beyond being organized by mold, I'm leaning towards either sorting my models within the molds based on either the year they were released, alphabetically, or by color, which is how I'll likely display them on my shelves. I'm still not sure yet, but a benefit to having your model horse collection inventory being on a digital format is that you can fairly easily change your mind and resort them whatever way you want. I'm going to give an example now on what it looks like for me to add a model onto my inventory list. I'm going to add one of the most recent models I acquired, Fabio. Now Fabio is the first model I have on this mold, so I'm first going to have to create a section for this mold. To find all the information for that, I go to identifyyourbriar.com. And here's a fun trick, if you're on desktop PC, use Control F and it will create a little search bar thing so you can type in the beginning of the mold name, for example in this case, Duende, and then boom, it takes you right to where you want to go. Now I don't use Mac computers, but I think the same shortcut on a Mac would be Command F. On Identify Your Briar, the Duende mold is also called the Spanish Stallion, so I'm going to create this section with both names on it. I'm also going to include the mold number, who it was sculpted by, and then the year it was released. Now that a section for the mold is created, I'm going to add the information for Fabio in a new row. Model name, Fabio, then the model number, which I found on Identify Your Briar, although it's also on its purchase page on briarhorses.com. For years produced, I'm putting 2020. Then comes his description. I usually like to put the special info about a model first, like if it's a Briarfest special run, a flagship dealer exclusive, etc. Therefore, for this guy, I'm going to put that he is a Collector Club web special. I think I'm also going to add that he is the Making a Splash Collector Club member choice model that was voted on in 2019. Then I'm going to put a short description of his color. He is a red dun splash pinto, so I'm going to put that down for his color. For condition, I'm going to put near mint. He was mint, but then he fell when I was taking photos of him, and he got a small dent in his paint and a tiny rub. Oops. Next is my column for price paid. Now he was $75 directly from Briar, but I personally like to include the cost of shipping when I do my inventory on models that I bought online, which means Fabio was actually closer to $90 for me. Therefore, I'm going to put $90 for his price paid. Then there is the show name column. I don't plan on showing this model, but I do already have a show name in mind for him, whether I show him or not, so I'm going to go ahead and put that down as well. Lastly is the placings column. Obviously, since I have not shown him, he does not have any placings, so I'm just going to leave that blank. And then that is it. His entry for my model horse inventory is done. That's the basic gist of my own model horse inventory list. I try to add any new models I get to the list right away, but I'm also still slowly adding the rest of my models in my collection by chunks. If you have a lot of models to inventory, don't try to do it all in one day. Spread it out. Maybe focus on only adding a few models a day or a handful every week. It can be overwhelming if you have a large collection and you're trying to inventory everything at once. I believe the earlier you start inventorying, the better, because then you won't be as swamped trying to inventory your entire collection later on down the line. I started inventorying my collection around over 2 years ago-ish, but I wish I would have started doing it a lot sooner, as I'm still working on trying to catch up with inventorying all my models, and it's still probably going to take quite a long time. There is an additional aspect to inventorying your models that you could do that I want to mention, which is to tag all your models or put a sticker on the bottom of their hoof. I've heard of collectors marking all their models with a tag or a sticker and putting their inventory or model number on them. If you show a large portion of your collection, you could also use the tags you use at live shows as a source of your model's information. That about wraps up this video. I hope you found it helpful or inspiring for inventorying your own collection. If it did, be sure to leave a like. Let me know down in the comments below what you're going to do for your model horse inventory list if you haven't started one yet. Or if you have an existing inventory list, let me know what you already do for it. What way do you organize it? What pieces of information do you include? Is there something you do for keeping track of your models that I didn't mention in this video? You can share that information with me and everyone in the comments as well. Thank you for watching. I hope you have an awesome day, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, everyone!